authentication and authorization processes are required to make a system secure and to make sure only authorized users have access of the restricted resources. Authentication is the process to determine the identity of the user trying to access the system. User has to present some evidence to prove the ID, like username and password, or biometric ID or digital key, which is recognized by the system and grant access permission to user. If multi-factor authentication is enabled, then more steps are required to complete the authentication process. Second step of security is authorization process, which checks whether user has permission for the resource which user is trying to access. For example, on a file storage system, any user can view and edit the file, but only admin user can delete the file. Then, if a non-admin user logs into system, then user can view the file. User is allowed to edit file content. But when user tries to delete the file, then system will return access denied or forbidden response to user. Generally, system uses some kind of storage system like database or NoSQL database system to persist user information. Microsoft Identity Platform provides modern standard-based authentication solution for applications. We will use Azure Active Directory to secure an API using Azure AD Authentication feature and access it using a MVC app. For demo, I have prepared a solution which contains two projects. First is Catalogue API and second is MVC Web App to fetch data from API. Download the solution from GitHub. GitHub repository link is in the description. Navigate to the link and log in to GitHub if not already logged in. Click here and then copy the URL and use any Git client or Visual Studio to clone, or click here to download a zip file and then extract it on your local machine. After cloning or unzipping files, go to the SRC folder. Double click on solution file to open it in the Visual Studio. If you have not installed Visual Studio, then install it first. We will enter settings value in app settings files. After registering apps in the Azure Active Directory, first we will register Catalogue API with Azure AD. Log in to Azure portal and open Azure Active Directory page. Click on App Registration Blade. Click on plus new registration link. Enter Gherkin.Catalogue.API in name text box. Select this option for supported account types, which allows users from multiple tenants. Leave the redirect URI blank and click on register button. Now click on expose an API link in the application menu blade. Click on add a scope link. Azure opens a panel at the right hand side. It displays an ID URI, something like API:// followed by an unique identifier. We can use this as it is, or we can define our own URI. But this URI should be unique. Leave it as it is and click on save and continue button. Enter products.view.all in the scope name text box. Select admin and users for who can consent. Enter view all products in admin consent display name and user consent display name text boxes. Enter allows the app to get all products in admin consent description and user consent description text boxes. Leave state enabled and click on add scope button. A scope will be added in the list. Now open overview blade. Copy the application client ID. Use this copy to clipboard icon, which appears when we hover over this link to copy the value. Now switch to the Visual Studio solution. Open appsettings.json file of Gherkin.Catalogue.API project. Paste copied client ID in the client ID and audience settings values. Next, copy directory or tenant ID from the overview and paste it in the tenant ID value of app settings file. Now close the Gherkin.Catalogue.API registration blade and open overview blade of Azure Active Directory. Copy primary domain from the tenant information box. Paste domain in settings file domain value. Now we will register the web app, which will connect to this API securely. Click on new registration and enter these settings. Name Gherkin.Catalogue.WebClient. Select again same option which we had selected for our API registration for supported account types. Click on register button. Now click on API permissions in application menu blade. Click on add a permission link. Azure will open a panel at the right hand side of the blade. There are three tabs in this blade. Microsoft APIs, APIs my organization uses, and my APIs. Click on my APIs. It will display a list of APIs registered by us. Select Gherkin.Catalogue.API from the list. It opens new panel. This panel displays delegated permissions and application permissions. We will learn about application permissions in later video. Select delegated permissions. It displays our exposed scope for Gherkin.Catalogue.API. Click on products.view.all permissions checkbox. Click on add permissions button. After permission is added, click on products.view.all permission link. Copy the whole scope URI and paste it in the Gherkin.Catalogue.WebClient projects appsettings.json files scopes and product API scopes settings values. Now select the Gherkin.Catalogue.WebClient project in Visual Studio solution. Right click on the Gherkin.Catalogue.WebClient project and select properties from the context menu. It would be the last item in the context menu. Click on debug tab and copy the SSL URL starts with https://. Switch back to Azure portal and on the authentication blade, click on plus add a platform link. Select web from the platform displayed on the right hand side. Now paste the URL which we have copied from the Gherkin.Catalogue.WebClient properties debug tab in redirect URIs text box. Add /sign-in at the end. So whole URL would look like https://localhost:443700/sign-in. Enter https://localhost:443700/sign-out in the logout URL. Select access token and ID tokens checkboxes. Click on configure button to save and add the platform. Open overview blade and copy application client ID. Now switch to Visual Studio solution. Open Gherkin.Catalogue.WebClient appsettings.json file. Paste copied client ID value in the blank client ID settings value. Now copy tenant ID from the Azure portal and paste it in the settings tenant ID value. Go back to portal and open the certificate and secrets blade. Click on plus new client secret link. Leave the description blank and 1 year option selected for the expires option and click on add button. A new secret will be added in the list. Copy the secret. This secret will not be visible once we leave the blade. So store it safely if we want to use it somewhere else. Paste it in the settings file client secret settings value. In the Azure portal, open the overview blade and copy primary domain from the tenant information box. Paste the domain in the settings file domain value. Now simultaneously press Ctrl Shift S keys or select Save All from File menu to save all files we have updated. With this, our configuration part is complete. Now it's time to test the setup. Make sure Gherkin.Catalogue.API project is selected as startup project. Name should be displayed in bold fonts. If not, then right click on the project and click on Set as Startup Project Context Menu Item. Make sure we are not using same browser for debugging which we are using for the Azure portal. Click here on the drop-down list and select a browser from the web browser submenu. I am using Firefox for the Azure portal, so I have selected Google Chrome for debugging. Press F5 key on the keyboard or click on this run button in top menu. Once project is running and opened in the browser, then in the Visual Studio solution, right click on the Gherkin.Catalogue.WebClient project and select debug and then start new instance from the context menu. Once this project is also opened in the browser, then click on sign in link. Enter username and then click on next. Or if you get a selection option, then select the account you want to use for the login to Azure. Now enter your password and click on sign in button. On the next screen, select whether you want to remain logged in on this browser or not. If you have two-factor authentication enabled, then you might get next screen to approve it. I am approving it using my phone. It will now display consent dialog box. We can see it is also showing view all products which we have added as a scope. If a user with admin privileges is logging in, then it will also display this checkbox. If admin checks this box and accept it, then it will be approved for the whole organization and other users will not get the consent selection. Click on accept button to provide the consent. Now sign in process is complete. Click on view all products. And we should get products from the API. Here is the products list from catalog API. Let's sign out and debug the code. Click on sign out and then Azure will display this dialog box. Click on the account link and we have now successfully signed out from the app. Let's set some breakpoints. One here in the products controller of client project. Another breakpoint is in catalog API projects products controller to show that it is hitting the controller to get the data. It also checks for the correct scope. If token does not contain correct scope, then it would return 403 forbidden response. Let's run both projects again. This time, directly click on View All Products link. It prompts to sign in again since we had signed out. Complete the sign-in process. This time we will not see the consent dialog box. It hits the breakpoint and here tries to obtain the token. One more thing worth mentioning here that this controller method is decorated with authorize for scopes attribute and it gets its value from the app settings product API scopes section. This is to make sure that authorization token contain these scopes. Continue debugging. We have got the token. Hover over the token and click on magnify icon to open the text visualizer. Copy the token to examine it using JSON Web Token Debugger tool. Open https://jot.ms in the browser and paste the token. It contains scope and audience claims which we have configured. Here is the scope with SCP key and here is the audience with AUD key. Let's continue debugging in Visual Studio. Here it makes a call to Catalog API. It hits the Catalog API products controller endpoint. Finally, it gets the data and returns to client. And MVC controller returns data to view. So this is how we can configure authentication and authorization in Azure Active Directory. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please leave your comments and suggestions below. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe the channel and hit the bell icon to get notified for the new videos.